Today we are bringing back one of my favorite series to do on this YouTube channel, where we take one thing and compare it to another, and then coming to a conclusion at the end as to which, in my opinion, of these two things are the best. And in today's video, as you can tell by the title, we will be comparing the Ray Gun from Cold War to the brand new Wonder Weapon CRBRS. We'll be looking how these weapons are obtained, how difficult it is, we'll be looking how they behave on the high rounds, and we'll be looking at just in general if they are better than one another. Before we fully get into it, be sure to subscribe. We are less than 150 subscribers away from hitting our goal of 25,000 subscribers, so thank you all so much. Also, be sure to drop a like on the video. Can we aim for 200 likes on this one? That would be pretty amazing if we could do that. Without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first thing I'm going to cover is how difficult these weapons are to obtain. And the first one that I'll cover is the Ray Gun. So the cool thing about this Wonder Weapon is that it is finally on a different map apart from Outbreak and the Machina. Unfortunately, the CRBRS itself is not on Outbreak, so we won't be able to do any comparisons there, but at least it was easier for me to look at both of these Wonder Weapons and compare them side by side. Now, how to obtain the Ray Gun on this map? From my knowledge, there is only one way, and that is through the box. Now, if you've played any matches on the Machina or even Outbreak, you know that obtaining the Ray Gun from the box can be a bit challenging. There are matches that you can go up to the box and hit it up to 50 or even more times and be extremely unlucky. Now, from my experience on Mauerder Toten, I don't know if it's just my luck, but the amount of times that I've gotten the Ray Gun, which is around 5 to 6 times, I was reasonably lucky to get the Ray Gun very fast. But then there are certain matches where you do need to hit it above 30 times, and aside from that, I don't think you can get it from the Bunny Dance Easter Egg, because the Bunny Dance Easter Egg on this map behaves a bit differently. There are 3 doors that you need to select, and once you pick the correct door, from my knowledge, you do not get the Ray Gun, but the CRBRS. I might be wrong about this. Now, moving on to the CRBRS, there are actually multiple ways of obtaining this Wonder Weapon, and it makes sense because it is its own special Wonder Weapon that we've never seen in the past. The first way we'll cover is from the box. I don't have actually any evidence of getting this, but I have been successful only once. I never really go for the box because there are way easier methods of unlocking this Wonder Weapon, but I just felt like mentioning that there is a way of getting it from the box. Another way is actually obtaining it from the trials, and at launch, I'll be honest, this is probably one of the easiest ways to get this Wonder Weapon. You could have been lucky to get it on your first go or even second go, but now from what I'm experiencing, it is actually very challenging to get it from the trials. I don't know if it's what Treyarch has done secretly, done some patch, or if it's just extremely RNG based and I was just really lucky in the past. I don't go for this method anymore, but it's definitely cool, as in the previous maps like the Machina, you were able to get the DIE, Firebase, you're able to get the Reike, and lastly on Mauerder Toten, you can get the CRBRS from the trials. Another method is through the Bunny Dance Easter Egg, as I've mentioned with the Ray Gun. Once you select the correct door, you should be able to see a floating CRBRS above the gold chest, and that's the way you know that you've chosen the correct door. This has only happened to me once, and I, again, also similar to the box, don't have any evidence of this, but trust me, once you select the correct door, you will see the Wonder Weapon floating and you'll know that you've chosen the correct door. So that is another way you can actually get it. And lastly, probably one of the easiest ways out of all 4 of these, and that is through the Easter Egg. All you have to do really is build Klaus, which you can do on round 10 since you can get the battery from the Panzer, and from there you get a special blacklight that then you have to shine on specific walls that will basically give you a safe combination, and all you have to do is put those numbers into the safe, which is also very easy because zombies won't attack you, and you basically get the Wonder Weapon. So if I have to decide which one of these is easier to obtain, I'll have to go with the CRBRS, because whereas with the Ray Gun you only have really one method on unlocking it, and I'm 100% sure that is the only way through the box itself, the CRBRS has multiple different ways. So if you, for example, can't get the free one, maybe because there's a bug or maybe because one of your friends took it, you can always do an alternative of doing the Dance Easter Egg, getting the box spins, or even completing a trial. So that has to go to the CRBRS. Now, one thing I need to cover as well is other variants of these Wonder Weapons. So again, moving on to the Ray Gun, there is only one version of this Ray Gun, but you can pack a bunch of 3 times, which improves its ammo and its damage like always. But with the CRBRS, there are 4 different variants. So there's a normal CRBRS variant, which shoots normal fast fire rate kind of ray bullets from what it seems, and it has a special little mimic ball that basically doubles your damage. In my opinion, this is the best version, and throughout the zombies communities, people can also agree, as this is mainly used for high rounding on Mauerder Toten. Another version is the Seeker variant, which basically can drop from zombies. So all of these variants can just simply drop from the zombies, which is a huge plus, as with the DIE, you had to specifically complete little Easter eggs here and there, which were relatively easy, but I think it's better to have a little bit of RNG from the zombies dropping these things for you. The Seeker variant basically shoots explosives, which in my opinion are very effective on the Panzer rounds, because they can just basically blow them up, since the Panzers take more damage from explosives like the Shatter Blast or anything that can just basically basically blow them up. Another one is called the Enlightenment, I'm pretty sure, unless that is its pack-a-punch name. Basically, this is a laser version of the Wonder Weapon, which is actually used for a bit of the Easter egg, and overall, it isn't great, but it's probably one of the more satisfying variants to use when there is an insta-kill, since you can just hold down the trigger and just basically laser through a horde of zombies, which is pretty cool. And the last one is called Quintessence, which in my opinion is probably the worst one, because this one is more of like a shotgun-based Wonder Weapon variant of this, and it shoots bullets kind of to four different locations, so it has a huge spread, and it does deal good damage when you obviously pack a punch the Wonder Weapon. But again, going back to what I said earlier, the base version of this Wonder Weapon, pack a punch, not pack a punch, is just the best version. So that's why we will stick onto that version onto this next part, because it is just the more powerful one, and the other ones are just, well, they're just poo-poo. Now, one little thing that I'll cover is the way these Wonder Weapons look, I guess. So going through all those variants, they definitely look very different, and the base version of the CRBRS really reminds me of the Cell 3 Cauterizer from Advanced Warfare. It's just a little thing that I felt like mentioning. Obviously, I'm not gonna choose which one is my favorite because of the way it looks. They all look really cool, the variants. Obviously, the Quintessence, I said it's bad, but it has a really cool look to it. Pack-a-Punch Camels look amazing on them. The Enlightenment just looks like this futuristic weapon that shoots the laser. They all look very nice with the camo. And the Ray Gun, well, it looks very similar to the way it did in the past from different Call of Duties. Obviously, they changed little things like the top bit of the Ray Gun is kind of lower. They removed some meters, some symbols here and there, but we're not going to be picky. Just felt like mentioning how these weapons look because I just thought it would be pretty cool to go over. And the last category, the finale of this all, is how these weapons behave on higher rounds. So by higher rounds, I mean round 55 and up, because round 55 is currently, as of now, the max health cap for zombies, and that is around 60,000 health, which is not a lot. The first weapon that we'll cover is the Ray Gun. It can deal between 8,000 to 15,000 damage on the zombies. I couldn't really find a certain amount of damage it'll deal without a Ring of Fire. Obviously, both of these Wonder Weapons, if you use a Ring of Fire, you will absolutely shred through the hordes of zombies, so there's no question about that. And the bad thing about this, from my knowledge, on normal zombies, it'll take you up to 3 shots with the Ray Gun for a zombie to fully go down. So the 8,000 to 15,000 damage you'll be dealing, you'll have to go through the 3 shots on the Wonder Weapon, and the Ray Gun itself has a pretty slow fire rate, so this can become a bit unreliable if, for example, you decide to train because of the Super Sprinters. And these are also, just to mention, with fully Pack-a-Punch, so Pack-a-Punch level 3 on both of these weapons. Now, moving on to the CRBRS, it is very similar to the Ray Gun from my knowledge, around 8,000 to 15,000 damage as well, without getting any headshot multipliers or anything like that. Now, with this one, it takes you to 3 to 5 shots to fully take down a zombie, but the interesting thing with this version is that it has a super fast fire rate, and I am talking about the basic version because that's the main one we're going to be comparing because it is the best one, and its super fast fire rate makes these zombies go very fast. Now, these two Wonder Weapons do drop off fast with its damage on the higher rounds, so again, a combination of the Ring of Fire with both of these makes everything so much better, but it's interesting how the fast fire and the slow fire rate really does make a difference. Even though the CRBRS takes more shots to take out a zombie without headshots, it does have a faster fire rate, and the Ray Gun takes a bit more less shots, but the slower fire rate on it can make it a bit of a disadvantage. And the final conclusion that I will come to, remember, I have a different opinion, you might have a different one as well. If you do, be sure to comment down below. I really would love to see what you think about this. And in my opinion, the better Wonder Weapon from overall on this map has to be the CRBRS or the Cerberus. Now, why do I say this? Not only does it have the 4 variants, but it also deals really good damage on the higher rounds. And I don't know if you know, but this Wonder Weapon is used for high rounding on Marauder Toten. There's a reason why people don't use the Ray Gun, and in my opinion, it could be because of the splash damage that it deals, and also because of its slow fire rate. Now, the Ray Gun will stay up there as one of my favorite Wonder Weapons in Cold War, and if they ever bring the Cerberus into Outbreak, I will probably use it there as well, depending on how much damage it'll deal on different zombies. Maybe they'll change it up a little bit, maybe it'll be dealing less damage on the Orda, but that's only something we'll find out in the future. So in conclusion, again, my favorite one, or the better one in my opinion, is the Cerberus, and I hope you agree with me in some kind of way. If you don't, again, share it down below. Hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to comment down below if you want me to continue this series, for example, comparing it to the DIE, or more preferably to the Reike. I will be working on those videos, but it would be pretty cool to see if you would like me to change it up in a little bit of a way. Feedback is always great. Thank you so much for subscribing, liking, and I'll see you all guys in the next one. Peace out.